It's the Ranger!
After him! I'll have your head!
Elves esteem delicate finery in all their arts, and the crystals in this artifact glow softly, even in a pitch black room. I know this firsthand because I'd often sneak into the Great Hall and read by crystal light when everyone thought I was safely in bed.
Thank you. finest crystal found in roughest Mordor. Fascinating.
Surprised the orcs didn't smash. Just to hear the sound.
This plate is of Easterling manufacture. The ceramic and the style of decoration is a sort unknown to me or anyone I've shown it to. I know that the Easterlings from beyond the Sea of Rune have never been friends to Gondor, and their war chariots and wain wagons are fearsome indeed. But I should like to meet one up close when battle is not at hand. No matter how fierce they are, they're still men, not Uruks or other minions of the Dark Lord.
The Easterlings. Stranger even than the Haradrim.
But just as vulnerable to entreaties from Sauron.
Faster than that!
Here we are.
Thank you.
Noruk.
To an orc, grog is strong drink for their bellies, but it's also medicine for their wounds, and so combustible that it may even be fuel for their war machines. Few Gondorians dare drink it, lest we start to behave like the orcs. Still, it is worth studying. Baranor has some ideas about a poison that, when mixed with grog, can disable or even kill the strongest orc.
This grog smells foul.
Ah, but to an Uruk it is ambrosia. Fuin.
After all.
Spiders!
Oh, those were meant for bowling. Not fine.
Carl.
Hidden blade in the wrist. The pink skins will never see it coming.
Did you hear that?
An intruder!
Kill him!
Come on, Ranger!
This artifact, a chunk of moonstone, was our last acquisition before the orcs came. A scout found it, still smoldering out in the fields where it fell to earth from the moon overhead. I am far from superstitious, but even I wonder whether this bit of fallen moonstone was meant to serve as an ill omen for the disaster that followed.
An ill omen from the skies.
Minas Ithil was doomed long before this moonstone fell to earth.
Ha!
I was. Must have been nothing.
The darkness.
Soon they will drown in my light.
Better not make me late for dinner. Go check over there.
Gondor's preferred order of battle with variations is a chart depicting how an army should be organized, from the frontline infantry to the cooks and teamsters in the rear. Whenever I study it, I'm amazed at what it takes to send an army to war. Details down to the number of cobblers and farriers for each column of soldiers. Such matters of supply seem mundane, until you're under siege, desperately fighting on quarter rations. Then, you're eager to pay attention to logistics.
The structure of Gondor's army, from general to foot soldier.
A structure the orcs will cast down the moment they set foot in Gondor.
Serve me!
Minas Ethil never had the grand dramas and pageantry of Minas Tirith itself, but we had simple arts like music to give us the solace of home. When all around us lies in shadow, a simple folk song or pleasing dance was a ray of sunshine. I wonder if such music will ever be heard again.
Is meant to learn the lute.
Your hands aren't meant for music, Talion. They have a more serious purpose.
Ruin you poisons every day.
Thank you.
fella. Take someone with skill to assassinate him.
The Sea of Nurn is home to beasts we can scarcely comprehend, but from time to time, clues about their existence wash up on the shore. Our patrols found this fossilized squid beak years ago. If it is proportional to the smaller squids that fishermen sometimes catch, the sea creature would be several hundred feet long. Such a monster is the stuff of nightmares, proof that this world hides horrors far worse than the orcs.
Beast, this must have been, and I doubt it was the last of its kind.